Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today you are getting the tutorial you've been waiting for, the new job based tutorial. So I have an idea. We're at 93 BPM. I tapped out the BPM. You can right click, tap your BPM. I came up with 93 or 94 BPM. And I have a melody in my head. So I'm going to record that to the metronome. Let's record notes on automation. You want a really good grand piano sound. You can get grand piano sounds almost anywhere now, but pick your favorite. Okay, you don't need this plugin specifically. So the melody starts before the downbeat. So it goes one, two, three, two. So let's one, two, three, and. I did that by accident, but that's fine. That can be our alternative. And actually, I stand corrected about it not being on the downbeat, meaning right when the metronome first hits. I'll show you how to build chords underneath this stuff. So that's the trick. You know, in our music theory essentials, we show you how to take one note and build chords underneath. Now, what I'm going to do is copy this. Since I played the wrong note, I'm going to go to snap to grip bar so I can just zoom out. I'm going to hold shift, left click, pull it over so it lines up. And at the end, I played the wrong note. So let's see. I meant to play. Let me see. Somewhere around here. Let's find it. That should be down here. I think. I forgot how it went now. Yeah, that's what it should be. Okay, so now we have two versions of that. Let's go to snap to grid, back to half step. Let's send that to the playlist and let's start building chords underneath this track. So I like to build chords when I deal with really high octaves. You know, chances are the chords are going to be two octaves away. You know, when you're dealing with these really high pitch notes. So here's what you can do to make this more simple. Start mapping out your scale. So let's just drag these notes in. Let's pull the volume all the way down and let's map out the notes we already have used. And then this gives us a better idea of which scale we're actually in. Okay, so we can see here we're using. And then our ear can let us know the rest of the tones which work. Bang. And then back to C sharp there or whatever nomenclature you want to use. Now, again, you don't need to memorize scales here. You just need to know which note you're playing. Let's hit shift, drag it down. Make sure the top and bottom note are the same. Okay, so that way you can just copy and paste. And now we have a reference to the notes which are going to work by default. Now, when you're dealing with jazz and stuff, sometimes you use notes that aren't in the scale. So that's why I don't want you to get caught up in scales, because it can really make you think you're doing something wrong, but you're not. Okay, so do not, when it comes to jazz especially, there's so many alternatives to chords and to the scale that you don't want to just get locked into it. So we got the first chord. Let's assume this is the top note of some chord. We're going to take that chord. Now, usually I play this by hand. Like, once you know the chords, I would go back, practice them, and then play it by hand. But since we're just doing it for the tutorial's sake, let's assume F sharp is our top note. All we want to do is grab F sharp and skip every other note going down the scale. That's a quick way to identify your chord. Okay, so you have F sharp, D sharp, B, and what was it? G sharp. I'm saying sharp because that's how it's listed here in FL Studio. So that's one chord option. We can extend it further by skipping the next note after G sharp, making that E. And that makes it a little more jazzy. You can even go further and then add the, make it really jazzy. And now it's super, this is a ninth chord. We have the first, third, fifth, seventh, ninth, actually 11th chord. I stand corrected. Now, to make this more playable, I'm going to pull that note down an octave. You know, chances are you're not playing all those notes spread out like that. Now again, you want to watch your velocity here. And I'm going to go chord per bar so it's not too complicated. Let's pull this to the right. So again, we go over these type of chords. At busyworksbeats.com/chordmagic, there's a whole course going in on these chords. So technically, this is an 11th, minor 11th, actually 0, 1, 2, 3, yeah, minor 11th. So all I did was invert that note. Okay, so once one was inverted, pulling it in between the chord, and one is just letting its natural voicing stand. Next chord we have here is D sharp as our top note. And let's start at D sharp. Now again, we want to be relative. Since F sharp was higher than this D sharp, I'm going to assume the same. I'm not going to pick the D sharp up here to start my chord. Let's pick the D sharp below the F sharp here. And I'm saying sharp again because that's how it's listed in this program. So please, the music theory nuts, leave me alone. This is for people who don't understand music theory right away. Okay? So we're going to go to D sharp, skip C sharp, go to B, skip A, go to G sharp, skip F sharp, go to E. That's going to help let us build out the full chord. And all we have to do really is follow the same chord. This is a different top note. Now I'm going to pull this down another octave so we can extend the chord further. Now I like this chord because it's a little lighter. I don't like all that bass. And it sounds like a different chord, even though we're playing the majority of this, you know, same notes. Now here I'm going to show you a trick. But let's make this a bigger chord before we do that. Let's do... And let's make this the 11th version of it. Just want to hear what it sounds like. That's very dissonant. So let's pull that up an octave. Still dissonant. So what I want to do here is convert this from a minor to a major. So we're taking it, you know, we go over this in our course material, Music Theory Essentials, but that's what we're doing here. Gives it a jazzy tone. And then we can go back to the minor version of the chord. Just, you know, to give it a little rhythm. And then just repeat the chord progression. Let's do that. I think that sounds pretty cool and jazzy. Now, one thing about piano is that when you're playing with what's called a sustain pedal, you're not going to have these gaps. It's just going to be long notes that look like this. It's not going to be like ding, 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 you know. So let's highlight these notes here, the overlapping notes. Actually, you can just hit control, left click, hit Alt L, and that will make sure the notes don't overlap themselves. And that way you can just drag out the notes. Now, again, this is a lot easier when you play it by hand, much more straightforward. But this way it doesn't stutter the notes in FL Studio. You hear that ding, ding, ding. That's because they're overlapping notes. So I have to fix that. Again, technical and arbitrary, but just keep in mind, that's what the sustain pedal is doing, elongating these notes. I want to change up the chords, so let's clone this, and I have an idea. But before we get to the idea, let's just edit the MIDI first. So let's copy this since it's finished and edited. Let's paste that into pattern 2, Control V. I just want to change up certain notes and or add in notes even. So here's where you get to have fun, you know. make sure you're on the, you know, on time. So I'm just doing this, you know, how I feel. No science to it. Actually, it sounds dissonant. So now I'm just adding little accents to make it separate from our first take. So, you know, I'm going in adding these grace notes. Now, keep in mind when I hit play, it's playing all the notes at once. That's why you hear this kind of weird slam on all the notes. So I have to zoom in, really hear, listen to the music. I'm gonna get rid of the G sharp there. Now we're going really high octave. I would spend more time and really dissect it, you know, and take it further. But now what we're going to do is sample ourselves. So let's add those two patterns to the playlist. Go to playlist mode. Go to your channel rack. Make sure the piano is routed to track one. I'm going to open up the plugin called Edison where we can record the MIDI into audio. Now that we have Edison open, let's record on input. And just in case you have a longer than 5 minute section, I'm going to put on 10 minutes. What I like to do with Edison is make sure there's a gap because it will just record again, you know, like the song will loop back on itself. I don't want it to, it's harder to tell where to cut when it does that. So I'm going to leave a gap in the playlist. Let's record on input. Actually, let's record on play and see if we get a better result here. Let's record on play. And now when I hit stop to reset it, I hit play. So I'll let it play all the way through up until the gap, then I'll stop the song. You can always go back and add little parts of the piano that you want to add in. Then you hit stop, then you go back to Edison. Make sure you hit stop in Edison so it stops recording. Now let's send that to the playlist as an audio clip. Now it's a new thing called an audio clip. So let's turn off the MIDI and make sure this lines up. So now it lines up. Thanks for the tip. I forget who sent it in, but thanks for the record on play tip instead of record on input. Now we can grab the slice tool. Snap the grid bar, hit shift, right click, get rid of the excess to the right. Now, if you really want to get, you know, crazy about it, you can go back into Edison and treat it as if it were a sample. So here's the key. This is where you get exotic, okay? Now, I want it as a regular piano, and I also want it as a chopped piano. So you could use the auto slicing tool. If you go to the marker tab, go to auto slice, go to medium auto slicing. That will slice it up into parts for you. Let me see if we can play with our keyboard. Okay, so now that we have that in Edison, let's zoom out. Make sure we highlight the whole clip. I'm left clicking in between the markers to grab the whole clip. Open up slice X, where we at? S-L-I-C. So now when we have the slice markers already in there, we can just drag it into slice X and it should carry over those markers. That way you could do the same thing in slice X, go to the regions tab, auto slice, medium auto slicing. You could do the same thing. Okay, it just converted that data over. And now we can play. I thought that sounded pretty cool. So now what I'm gonna do is keep the piano to the side as maybe a bridge or something. Let's save it as a new project. And let's program in our drums. So the reason I'm programming the drums now is because I want to create the groove so we can play the... Now let me record that just so I don't forget the rhythm and the keys I'm playing. Then we're going to go, you know, in a different thing. So I just want to keep that as a record. Now let's go to find some drums. I'm just going to pull up some random drums. And let's see, let's create a boom bap style rhythm. So first I want to hear the piano sound so I can kind of match the tone. I like this kick. This one's a little too big for this track. We need something a little more lax. Start back at the top. These kicks are from Conant Gardens from the Machine Library. I just imported the sample folder. Let's go with the streets. Okay, let's right click, open that up. Okay, and let's see. We need a snare to go along with it. Let's grab a snare. Again, I want to hear the piano so we know what we're matching up as far as tones. Turn off the metronome. We can add that as the tail end of the snare. Let me just create a scratch drum rhythm and let's add that piano rhythm that I had. Even though we're probably going to change up the drum rhythm. Add in pattern 4. Let's start with the kick. I'm going to show you how to make the kick sound better than that. Just to get the tones right. This is pretty cool. I like that one. It has a little hi-hat tail. Adds a nice little bounce to it. And let's add a hi-hat here. All right, so let's make this sound more realistic. Let's right-click, fill each 2 steps to the hi-hat. Now I usually switch up my drums, but I mean, I usually put the hi-hats on a different track. Let's go to the wrench tool, turn up time shift for the hi-hats. That way it delays those hi-hats. You can clone this if you want more drums or whatever you want to do. You know, change up your drums. Let's just start with pattern 4. We can always branch out from there. Let's start with that hi-hat. Let's create that groove. Let's go to the side stick. Let's go to the wrench tool. Let's turn up this time shift so the side stick hits later after the snare. It's very quiet, so let's turn up the level adjustment. Let's also do that with the kick. Now the kick to me feels a little late, delayed. I don't know if that's how I played the piano or what. Now here's some other tricks for the kick. Go to piano roll. zoom in with your mouse wheel. And every time you have a double kick or a back-to-back kick, pull the kick before it down in volume. You don't have to do it on everyone. Just adds a little more dynamic. Now the piano sounds a little early to me, you know, the way I played it. So let's go inside pattern three. Hit Alt Right, 1, 2, 3. Just make it fit in the groove. Now what I'm gonna do to keep that groove, let's just snap our grip to bar mode. Hit Control, highlight your notes, hit Shift, left click, pull it over. And now all we have to do is just change out the note value. So remember, I wanted to change chords. Boom, 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 boom. So let's figure out. So we're going to change marker, what is this, 24 to this one, number 37. And our second, boom, boom. We can do 38 or 39. I think 38 has a little more clarity. Boom, 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 boom. And then 42. So we're just remapping the note value. Turn that kick down. Should be dum dum dum. This should be 34. So even though I picked the wrong chord, it sounded cool, but then at the end I wanted to resolve. And also the notes play for however long you drag them out. So if you want a more elongated sound, you have to drag out your notes and slice X. Let's add some effects to the piano. Switch up the kick pattern a bit. Also gonna add a little time shift to the kick and a little swing. Not a lot. Also go to your plugins where you don't want the swing to affect the sound, like our Slice X, go to the wrench tool, turn off the swing mix so it doesn't affect the way the piano plays. Spice up the track a little bit with mixing. Let's add some delay in here. Now let's hear what it sounds like with the piano behind the track and the drums. Sounds really cool with just the piano. Let's go to track 100. Let's add that reverb in there. I'm gonna use my favorite Lexicon. You can use any reverb you want. Piano to the reverb, and I want to take off any built-in reverb since we already recorded it, but you want to make sure the reverb is out off. And now you can get creative. So let's say they listen to the whole piano thing and then you want to change it up at the end. Let's make that unique, make this unique, and then create little change ups like dun dun. So I'm just adding my own little stutters. So, you know, we're just adding accents, just like we did with the melody in our chord progression. Kind of hard to hear it, so I'm going to delete the bottom note. And just swap that out. So I think that sounds cool. Now if it's too much overlap, I'm just going to delete the bottom note. Here it's a little weird with the timing. Let's hear it with the track. I'm gonna turn these up. I'm gonna copy the same section over. Now again, remember, these are very quantized notes compared to the way we played it. It's not quantized. At a bass line. I might add my own guitar. Let me plug up my bass guitar. It needs to be tuned, so I'm going to quickly tune it. I'm going to turn up my mic so you can hear the interference. Close enough. Now I meant to check the piano to make sure it was at 440 hertz tuning, just to make sure you understand the tuning of your piano. Let's open up the guitar. I'm not a bass player by any means. I'm just gonna go by feel, and if I don't like it, we're just gonna scrap it. So I like that. So I'm just gonna, you know, improv the bass. Might not have the best timing, but that's fine. So here's my bass line, I think. And then I add it at the end. Something like that. So let's just record that. Record notes on automation. Now let me make sure I'm... Let me practice the downbeat, because I forget what the downbeat is. So... the downbeat, boom boom. So you know, okay, so just make sure you understand what the downbeat is. Record note automation audio into playlists. Pretty clean take. I liked it all the way through. Played a couple sour notes, but I'm just gonna keep the whole thing the way it is. Now let's beef up the bass with some mixing. Let me just put the bass guitar back. Start mixing the bass. It needs a little more grit, so we're gonna add a preamp to it. I'm gonna run it through some UAD plugins. I think I have this one. I'm not sure if I do or not. If you listen close, you hear that grit. That's because I'm driving the input. Flip the phase of the kick, stands out a little bit more. I think the drums need a little saturation. Let's try grouping the drums. I let's add a saturation plugin here. Now, Isotope might be good here. Let's try Isotope Exciter. So start with Triode. I like Tube. Let's just hear what it sounds like. Yeah, I like the tone here. So you gotta be careful here not to take out too much low end, because that's what can happen if you do too much saturation. Change up the drums every fourth thing, so it's not the same thing over and over. Let's make it unique. And if you want to, you know, let's delete the whole thing. Highlight the drums, go to playlist options, go to edit, go to merge pattern clips. That's going to, you know, make it all one big clip. That way we can edit it and copy and paste it a lot easier. Okay, so now you want to also think about other elements like flutes, saxophones. The only thing is, there aren't too many good saxophone plugins out there. Native Instruments offers one in the Session Horns Pro. You can add that in if you like that tone. I like the Sax Brothers. I'm also going to add a compressor to our bass. Let's do the VC76. No, wrong bass, sorry. Wrong compressor. I meant to add the VC160. From Native Instruments. I only wanted to capture the peaks. Output gain. That EQ to the bass. I should probably turn my monitors on so I can mix this with the monitors. So let me do that now. So let me go back and add a little more low end to the track. I'm going to turn off my mic because I'm playing my speaker monitors, so there's no feedback. And I'm going to add a little more low end bass. So I lowered the bass down an octave so it could fit in a different bass range so that you could feel it. You know, before you could hear it, but you couldn't really feel it over my system. Now I'm going to probably change that decision later, but that's an option for you if your bass isn't low enough. The reason I don't play low octave bass is because I can't really tell the pitch. It's really hard to tell the pitch on bass guitar. So I like to play it in a higher octave. And you can always lower the octave just like I did. Okay, so let's look for some other elements like a flute, saxophone even. Let's load up contact. That's probably gonna take a while to load, so I'm gonna cut the video. Okay, so some options I would consider for a sampler. Let me make sure I'm not sending this to the group track, which is track 9. Session Horns Pro has a saxophone. Let's go inside contact. So I would, you know, if you're going to add guitar, there's Veer 2 acoustics and Veer 2 electricity. I like those for acoustic and electric guitar. For saxophone, I go with Session Horns Pro, solo instruments, and then your choice of the saxophone. Let's just load up the alto and play along. So let's still loading samples, but let's play along with the track. Gonna do that on a turnaround. Listen, so I'm playing this. It's gonna add a ton of delay and reverb to give it that tone that we like. So I like to tuck it way in the mix. I don't really like it as a forefront element. I've heard of Sax Brothers, and that sounds incredible. So you want to look that up, but it's very expensive. You know, if this is just one instrument in your collection, but go for it if you love it. Fruity Delay 3. Ping Pong, turn the pan width up. Now let's send it to the reverb, of course. I think that's a nice touch. Let's get a flute from Nexus, and I believe it's in the classical section under woodwind. We have the flute, and I picked the wrong thing. Still picked the wrong thing. Here we go. So I might do that. I'm going to put the mod tab, put legato on, so you get that pitch bend effect. I might just play the same thing. Same thing as the sax, just to keep it in unison. I think that's probably the best way to go. All we gotta do is just copy and paste. We don't even have to do anything. Copy and paste. Let's pull it up an octave, control up. Just turn it down in the mix. Maybe pan one hard left, hard right, so they have, so you can hear them separately. Add the same delay, click the down arrow, save preset as. Take off the delay in Nexus so it doesn't have its own delay, and take off the reverb, and then send that track to the, let's right click, copy the value from track 10 and paste the value for track 11 so they have the same amount of reverb. You can even add some strings in there if you want. Might be a little overkill, but freestyle to it just to show you how to mix the vocals, then we'll wrap it up. Mastering, and then we'll wrap it up. you learned a lot. We went through a lot. I'll probably chop out the dead spots in the video, but we went through a lot today. The new Jabez tutorial you've been waiting for. One of my friends in college used to love listening to his music for inspiration. So thanks for watching today. If you want to learn more about music theory, which got us through this whole thing, go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. I'm going to show you all the stuff, the reasons why this stuff works, scales, chord progressions, chords, how to take one note, turn it into a chord progression, how to take one note and turn it into a chord. This stuff is possible. We showed you today. It's very elegant. Go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. I'll leave a link below this video. You can get started today. There's free videos on the page for you. So thanks for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com.